why do we need vector functions at all? Why don't we just break them down in their component functions and study those instead? We need vector functions because of their interpretations, for example as space curves. The components mean something together, in this case the coordinates of a point in 2 or in 3 space. In this video, we will see how we can visualize vector functions as space curves into space using a few examples. So what do we have? A vector function from some domain to R2, so two components, where the domain is some subset of R. That's wrong. So our R of t will be consist of two components, f of t and g of t, and we will interpret this as points in R2. So if we let t run, we get all kinds of points f of t, g of t for all values of t, and together they will form a curve in R2. So we'll interpret our vector function as a space curve. So the components f of t will be the x coordinate of our function and g of t will be the y coordinates of our curves. So let us look at a few examples. For example, the function 1 plus t, 2 minus 2t. So we have as components two linear functions, so it looks very easy. So what kind of space curve will this give us? Well, let's plug in a few values of t. For t equals 0, for example, we get the vector 1, 2, which is over there. And for t equals 1, we get 2, 0, so that's the vector over here, depicted by a red dot. For t equals minus 1, we get 0 and then 4, so we are over there. And if we can plug in 2 points in between as well, t equals minus 1 half, t equals 1 half, we get in between. And we say, hey, it looks like all those points are on a straight line. We just plug in 5 points here, so maybe if we would continue, the points would end up somewhere else. But as far as we can tell, the points seem to be on a straight line. And we can check that, of course, by eliminating the t from our vector function. Because we have x equals 1 plus t, we can solve for t, then we get t equals x minus 1, and then we can plug that in into y, and then we observe something. Because we have y equals 2 minus 2t, plug in the t, we get 2 minus 2 times x minus 1, which yields 4 minus 2x. So our equation yields y equals 4 minus 2x, which is exactly in line with intersection at 0, 4 and slope minus 2. We can rewrite our r of t slightly as follows. You take apart everything with the t in a vector over here, and everything without the t in a vector over here. And this is a general way to write a line. It's of the form r0, where r0 is a vector from the origin towards a point on the line, plus t, our parameter, times v, where v is the direction vector, a vector on the line. You can see it in this figure over here, where the total line is drawn in yellow. So a general parametric equation of any line can be written as this: r0, vector from the origin to any point on the line, plus t times v, where v is a vector in the direction of the line. Let's look at a slightly more complicated example. R of t equals cosine t sine t. So x of t equals cosine t, y of t equals sine t. And if we plug in a few values of t, for t equals 0, we are at x equals 1, y equals 0, t equals pi over 4, then x and y are 1 half square root of 2, and t equals pi, we are at minus 1, 0. And if you plug in a few more values, you see other red dots, t equals pi over 2, 3 pi over 4, etc. Then you see, hey, it looks like all those points are on a circle. And is this true? Well, we can see, but now we have to use a slightly different trick. We have x of t equals cosine t and y of t equals sine t. If we compute x squared plus y squared, we get sine squared t plus cosine squared t. And we see if we add those up, the t drops out and we get a 1. So what we see, indeed, our points in the xy plane satisfy the equation x squared plus y squared equals 1. So they are indeed on the circle.